How we feel determines how we think. And it affects all parts of how we think. So it affects how we perceive stimuli. It affects how we make decisions. You can imagine going to the grocery store hungry, you're gonna make different decisions than if you go to the grocery store full. And it also affects how we move. So if we're sleepy, we move differently than if we're super alert. What I've been studying is how these kinds of internal states, motivation, arousal, that sort of thing, affect our neural coding of movement. If I were to give you a task to do, like putting a golf ball into a cup, and we could arrange things so that you're about 70% at getting that golf ball into the cup. And then I were to say to you, I'll give you $1 each time you get that ball into the cup. Most people do better. Do a little bit better than 70% under that scenario. And I could say, I'll give you $2 each time you get that ball out of the cup. And most people will do a little bit better yet. But if I told you, I will give you $10,000 each time you get that ball into the cup, statistically speaking, most people do worse. Choking under pressure is a ubiquitous phenomenon. We see it a lot in sports, but it occurs in a lot of other environments too, and it also occurs in the lab. You can study this. Statistically speaking, when incentives become very high, people do worse. And we're not really sure why. What is it about the neural mechanisms of how we create movement that makes them be suboptimal when you should be performing at your best? One of the major things my lab studies is how to design a brain-computer interface. So a brain-computer interface is a device that is hoped can restore motor control abilities to people who have lost it due to injury or disease. The idea is that we could record neural signals directly from the brain and then use those neural signals to control a device such as a cursor on a computer screen or a robotic arm. What we found so far is that rewards impact motor planning. So it turns out we plan actions before we execute them. On the horizon, one of the things we'd really like to do is to give people feedback about how rewards are impacting their motor planning and potentially manipulate that process, for example, to cure choking under pressure. And so the idea is to use a brain-computer interface, give a subject volitional control over those reward signals, and through that, stabilize behavior so that you can perform optimally in situations when you need to perform optimally. To me, it's really interesting to consider how our emotional state, how our internal state, how that regulates how we think and the computations that our brain performs. So the study we've been working on is rather narrowly focused on reward and motor control. But thinking more broadly, we're really interested in how internal states and emotions regulate brain-wide neurocomputation. And so in the long future, that's where we'll be headed, to understand how these kinds of internal state signals manipulate how brain areas communicate with one another and how they perform computations.